Hello friends. The smart home sensors that react to people can generally be divided into two classes, and I'll specify that this refers to the majority of devices available on the market. These are motion sensors and presence sensors. What is their key difference? Motion sensors have an infrared sensor that responds to heat. If you are a vampire or a reptiloid, they will perform very poorly. The plus side is that these sensors are passive and can operate for years on a single small battery. The downside is that they are not sensitive enough and easily lose track of stationary objects. Presence sensors use microwave radar, which sends out pulses and receives reflected signals. If an object enters its field of view, the reflection begins to change, and the sensor detects movement, even the slightest, including breathing. This is its advantage. The disadvantage is that the radar is an active device and requires stationary power. The hero of this review is an attempt to combine the advantages of both types of sensors, the sensitivity of microwave and the autonomy of infrared. We will find out how successful this attempt was. Before we start, please like this video, as it helps it reach more people interested in smart home topics, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so before. Device type, combined motion, presence, and light sensor. Sensors, infrared and 24 GHz microwave radar. Protocol, Zigbee 3.0. Range, motion up to 10 meters, presence up to 6 meters. Sensitivity settings, 10 levels. Presence interval setting. Coverage angle, 105 degrees. Illuminance, from 0 to 3000 lux. Power supply, 2 AAA batteries, 1.5 volts. Operating temperature range, from minus 10 to 55 degrees Celsius. Sensor size, 72 by 32 by 20 millimeters. Base size, 52 by 2 millimeters. The device comes in a small white cardboard box. Due to the stickers, I did not immediately realize what it was. It took about 2 weeks from the time of order to delivery. The package includes the sensor itself, a small manual, and mounting hardware. Batteries are not included. You need to provide them yourself. The manual is in two languages, Chinese and English. There's nothing particularly important here. The sensor is mounted on a movable base, which can be attached to the wall using the included tape or with screws, though screws are not included in the package. The sensor has a rectangular shape with rounded edges, dictated by the type of batteries used. On the front, there is a semi-transparent hemisphere for the infrared sensor, and below it, an activity LED. The microwave radar operates through the casing, so no special window is needed for it. Later, we will check whether it actually has a 24 GHz version. This combination of two sensors significantly improves the energy efficiency of the device. Typical presence sensors operate continuously, sending and receiving signals in the microwave range, thus requiring stationary power. In this case, the radar is mostly inactive, turning on only when the motion sensor is triggered, making it possible to use batteries. The presence of a base, which allows the sensor to be tilted, raised, and rotated, is a significant advantage. This gives you the ability to precisely adjust the area each will monitor. The rear cover, to which the base is attached, is removable. However, considering that the base will be permanently fixed, it is actually the sensor that is removable. Underneath it, there is a battery compartment for 2 AAA batteries. Prying it open from the edges, it's held by clips, we extract the entire sensor from the case. As we can see, there are indeed two sensors, the infrared motion sensor under the hemisphere and the microwave radar, which is square and located to the right in this photo. This is a Hi-Link manufactured module, model LD2410S, operating at 24 GHz. It requires 3V power, which is provided by 2 batteries, and it activates only when the motion sensor is triggered. For those interested in reading more about this radar, I will leave a link to the manufacturer's official website with its specifications in the description below the video. Interestingly, such modules are also used in DIY devices, for example with ESP32 and ESP Home firmware. It's time to move on to the logical part of the review, for which we need to install batteries in the compartment. To pair the device, hold the button located there until the LED starts flashing. As per tradition, we'll start with the basic ecosystem, Tuya Smart, and the same goes for Smart Life. Since our review's hero operates via Zigbee, we need a corresponding gateway, and within its plugin, we need to enable the addition of child devices. The hero of our review was added correctly and identified as a presence sensor. At this stage, no problems were encountered. This is what the device plugin looks like. At the top, one of three detected statuses is displayed: no presence, active motion presence, and low mobility presence. Below it, there are several options, data from the light sensor, and various settings. I will clarify another important point. Microwave presence sensors work well through obstacles. For example, one of mine is located in a plastic mounting box behind ceramic tile. Let's put this sensor in the box. It currently displays a status of low mobility presence. After some time, the sensor will indicate that there is no one there. However, even though the radar can easily penetrate through the cardboard box, the sensor remains inactive even if you pick up the box. This happens because the radar is turned off, and it needs a signal from the infrared sensor to turn on, which does not work through obstacles. Only when it is taken out will the motion sensor trigger, which in turn activates the radar. Thus, this model cannot be used through obstacles like its counterparts with stationary power. Now let's move on to the other options. The light sensor displays values in lux, and you can open a graph over days, months, and years. There is an option to view a tab with a log of triggers. In the automation tab, there will be all the scenarios linked to the sensor. Settings tab. There are quite a few settings here, and apparently, some of them pertain to another version, in particular the timer for setting and disarming, alarms, and doorbell. I assume that a version with a siren exists or is planned for release. Next is the setting for the presence interval, which is the time from the last motion detection to the state of being disabled. There are settings for the range and sensitivity of the radar, and there are special settings to reduce false triggers. You can enable notifications for detecting presence and transitioning to the disabled state. They look as shown on the slide in the center. There is quite detailed online documentation available. In the general settings menu, there is information about compatibility with third-party systems. Only Amazon Alexa is listed here. I do not have the opportunity to test it, but the device does not work with Google Home and Apple HomeKit. Here, you can also check the firmware of the device, share access, and remove it from the system. Let's look at the capabilities of the device and automations. The sensor can function both as a trigger and as an action. For the if section, it has five event options. State: here there are four options, whether there is presence or not, as well as the duration of these states, which is indicated right here. Battery charge level: more, less, or equal to a selected value. Operation mode: alarm or doorbell, but this seems to be from another model, as without a siren it makes no sense. Type of movement: there are four types. Besides active and low mobility, there is also slight movement, though I have never seen this in the sensor. And light level: more, less, or equal to a selected value. For the then mode, actions, there are three options available. To be more precise, these are not actions, but settings of the sensor itself that can be changed, for example, depending on the time of day. You can change the sensitivity and detection range of the radar, as well as the presence interval. For example, you can increase it during the day and decrease it at night. As I mentioned earlier, the device is not supported by Google Home and Apple HomeKit, so let's move directly to Sonoff iHost, a local smart home control center. You can find links to its reviews in the video description below. The current firmware version at the time of this review is 1.13.7. We initiate the device pairing mode and press the button to put the sensor into pairing mode. After some time, it is added to the system. However, as of the review date, the sensor is not supported and cannot be used. Now, let's move on to Home Assistant. At the time of testing, the current version is April 1st, 2024. Home Assistant itself does not work with devices directly. It uses integrations. The default one is called ZHA. I use a DIY USB stick with SkyConnect firmware as the coordinator. You can find a link to its review in the description. Press the button to connect devices. We press the button to put the sensor into pairing mode and wait for it to complete the interview process and be added to the system. At this point, it is encouraging to see that some objects have been transferred into the system. Apart from the identification button, there are three entities here: a binary motion sensor and sensors for light level and battery charge. The binary sensor has only two states: on when there is motion, and off when there is none. There are no settings for sensitivity or presence interval here, so I became curious about how long it will take, after detecting motion, for it to switch to the disabled status. To test this, I took the sensor to another room, waited for it to reset, approached it again to make sure the LED on the casing blinked, indicating that the sensor had been triggered, then returned and began waiting for it to switch to the disabled status. I had to wait quite a long time. At first, I even thought it might have disconnected, but it was working. From my observations, it transitions to the no presence status almost 7 minutes after the last motion detection. I repeated the test several times, and the results were roughly the same. The light sensor, from observations, works normally. It updates immediately upon motion detection and occasionally otherwise, as the sensor spends most of its time in sleep mode. Overall, if you do not need a quick transition to the disabled state, the sensor is usable in ZHA. Now, it's left to test the hero of our review with Zigbee 2 MQTT, the current version at the time of testing being 1.36.1. The good news is that there is built-in support. The sensor is supported out of the box, and there is no need for creating external converters. The description and image are accurate. I should also mention that the sensor is an end device, as it operates on batteries and spends most of its time in sleep mode. Quite a few objects were identified here. Presence detected or not, type of movement, large, which I would call active, or low mobility. Light level and lux, battery charge level and percentage, which we'll update later. Settings for presence interval in seconds, distance in meters, and sensitivity. There is an option to disable the LED indicator and a signal quality level. The minimum level for all settings is 0. By the way, before making any changes, the sensor needs to be woken up. The maximum values are 28,800 seconds for the interval, 10 meters for the distance, and level 10 for radar sensitivity. For testing, I set these values, 15 seconds, 3 meters, and the middle, 5th level of sensitivity. Let's check. I took the sensor to the next room and waited until both the presence and motion sensors turned off. Then I approached and immediately left the sensor. The presence sensor activated. The status changed to home, and after 5 seconds, as seen in the history, the motion sensor displayed the status of active, which I will refer to as active movement. Here is the entire chronology of events. Presence sensor triggered, status home. Then, a 4-second difference. The motion sensor displays active movement. I remind you that I immediately left the sensor, and no one was nearby. After another 15 seconds, it changed to the status of static, low mobility. And 2 seconds later, the status changed to away. And 5 seconds after that, the presence sensor also turned off. The whole process took less than 30 seconds, although the duration of the interval was set to 15. And this is its behavior when someone is in the room. The presence sensor remains active. It holds quite well, in my observations, while the motion sensor periodically changes the type of activity detected. This is how I installed the sensor on the wall, in a corner near the door, so that it would not interfere with anyone and was directed at human height, to not react to small pets. As of the release of this video, it has been working for just a couple of days, with no complaints so far. I generally like this sensor. It's slightly more expensive than the usual motion and presence sensors from the Tuya ecosystem, but it combines the autonomy of one with the sensitivity of the other. By autonomy, I mean only the ability to operate on batteries, as I do not yet know how long they will last. It features a genuine 24 GHz microwave radar and a light sensor. As a downside, relative to presence sensors, it should be noted that it cannot operate through obstacles because the radar needs a signal from the infrared motion sensor to start. Overall, I can recommend purchasing at least a trial unit to experiment with the settings and understand how well it meets your needs. That's all. I hope this video was useful and interesting to you, and I would appreciate your likes as they help promote it on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and tutorials, subscribe to my channel. In the description, I will leave links to stores where you can order this sensor, to other mentioned reviews, as well as my Telegram channel, Facebook page, and a group for discussing smart home topics. Join us, it will be interesting. Thank you for your attention, and until next time, peace to all.